The content filter identifies spam by looking at the email content. It checks the body text, the headers, and other pieces of information to determine the probability of an email being spam. Emails are assigned a rating between 0 and 9, known as the Spam Confidence Level, or SCL. The higher the rating, the more likely for an email to be spam. An email with SCL 9 is almost certainly spam. Likewise, SCL 0 is assigned to emails that look perfectly legitimate. SCL ratings between these two extremes indicate a varying degree of certainty. This rating logic is based on data Microsoft gathers and makes available for download through the Microsoft Update service. These updates help the content filter to keep up with the latest spam waves, allowing it to identify new spamming trends. In this video series, we already discussed sender ID filtering. You may remember that sender ID provides a stamping option. Stamps report the sender ID result without blocking emails. The content filter reads these stamps and uses the information to improve its rating logic. To turn the content filter on or off, we configure the set content filter config enabled parameter. Next, we configure a number of filtering actions that the content filter applies. These are tied to SCL thresholds. Whenever the email SCL rating matches or exceeds a threshold, an action is applied. In all, we have three thresholds: the delete, reject, and quarantine. Delete silently drops emails without letting the sender or recipient know. This is the most severe blocking action. Reject also blocks email delivery. However, it returns a rejection response to the sender. Quarantine is the least severe, as it allows us to review blocked emails. Here, emails are rerouted to a central mailbox. Here is an example of how these thresholds could be set. Being the most severe, delete takes the highest threshold value. We only delete when the likeliness of false classification is almost nil. On the other hand, quarantine is used with lower SCL ratings, as it gives us the opportunity to verify blocked emails. Each of these thresholds can be enabled and individually set. It is not uncommon for administrators to prefer reject over delete. In that case, we disable delete and enable reject. Here, I enable the delete threshold and set it to 8. This enables the reject action, setting it to 6. Before configuring the quarantine threshold, we set the mailbox where spam is to be deposited. We set the quarantine mailbox parameter. Next, we enable and set the quarantine threshold. Apart from these actions, Exchange provides a fourth threshold that is not configured at the content filter. This is the junk folder threshold. An email exceeding this threshold is moved to the Outlook junk folder. This is the least severe filtering action and is only applied if the content filter doesn't block the email itself. The junk threshold is configured using set organization config. Here I am setting it to 3. Emails are moved to the junk folder whenever the SCL is greater than the threshold. Note that this is different from the content filter thresholds, whose actions are applied when the threshold is matched or exceeded. The junk folder threshold action is only applied when exceeded. So setting the threshold to 3 will catch emails with SCL 4 or higher. This completes today's video. Here we started discussing the content filter. We saw how the filter works and configured global thresholds that apply to all processed emails. There are more useful configuration options that are important when configuring the content filter. We will discuss these in the next video. Subscribe to the WinDeveloper YouTube channel for the next part of this video series.